Magandang araw, kapamilya. Today is Thursday of the 25th week in Ordinary Time. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. I am the salvation of the people, says the Lord. Should they cry to me in any distress, I will hear them, and I will be their Lord forever.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and of our neighbor, grant that by keeping your precepts, we may merit to attain eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. Vanity of vanities, says Kohelet. Vanity of vanities. All things are vanity. What profit has man from all the labor which he toils at under the sun? One generation passes and another comes, but the world forever stays. The sun rises and the sun goes down, then it presses on to the place where it rises. Blowing now toward the south, then toward the north, the wind turns again and again, resuming its rounds. All rivers go to the sea, yet never does the sea become full. To the place where they go, the rivers keep on going. All speech is labored. There is nothing one can say. The eye is not satisfied with seeing, nor is the ear satisfied with hearing. What has been that will be, what has been done that will be done. Nothing is new under the sun. Even the thing of which we say, see, this is new, has already existed in the ages that preceded us. There is no remembrance of the men of old, nor of those to come will there be any remembrance among those who come after them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Let our response be, in every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge.
In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge.
You turn man back to dust, saying, return, O children of men, for 1,000 years in your sight are as yesterday, now that it is past, or as a watch of the night.
In every age, O Lord, you have been a refuge.
You make an end of them in their sleep. The next morning they are like the changing grass, which at dawn springs up anew, but by evening wilts and fades.
In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge.
Teach us to number our days aright, that we may gain wisdom of heart. Return, O Lord, how long? Have pity on your servants.
In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge.
Fill us at daybreak with your kindness, that we may shout for joy and gladness all our days. Prosper the work of our hands for us. Prosper the work of our hands.
In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge. Alleluia, alleluia. I am the way and the truth and the life, says the Lord. No one comes to the Father except through me. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Herod the Tetrarch heard about all that was happening, and he was greatly perplexed because some were saying, John has been raised from the dead. Others were saying, Elijah has appeared. Still others, one of the prophets, one of the ancient prophets, has arisen. But Herod said, John I beheaded, who then is this about whom I hear such things? And he kept trying to see him. My dear brothers and sisters, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
It's very interesting because it's almost like the gospel for today and the gospel for tomorrow. Para siyang magkasunod talaga sila no, sa, in the gospel of St. Luke. But for our own reflections, it's almost like we need to reflect on the two gospels side by side. Because today you have the person of Herod, again, being very fascinated by Christ. And then tomorrow you have that, again, that beautiful encounter between Jesus and his disciples. Who do people say that I am? So here you have Herod. Again, if you notice, kung matatandaan natin, si Herod palagi siyang fascinated by John the Baptist. Remember, nakaaway niya si John the Baptist, siya yung nagpapugot ng ulo kay John the Baptist. But at the same time, in the gospel narratives, it's always mentioned that Herod wanted to listen to John the Baptist. He enjoyed listening to him. He was perplexed. He was fascinated. But eventually, you know, nadala siya, remember, in the beheading, nadala siya dahil hiningi nung anak ni Herodias. No? So here again, you have Herod being pictured as someone who is fascinated by Jesus Christ. And maybe that is the first point that I invite you to reflect on. You know, I remember back in our philosophy courses, I think the guy is Otto. No? He talks about the Mysterium Fascinosum and the Mysterium Tremendum. He says that, you know, that we are at one at the same time fascinated by the divine, and also there's a certain fear, there's a tremendum of the divine. No? And here you have Herod, who clearly shows that fascination and clearly has that attraction to listen to John the Baptist and now the person of Christ. No? He wanted to know him. He wanted to meet him. But you realize that ang lesson dito kay Herod, hindi sapat yung tayo ay naaakit, hindi sapat yung tayo ay na parang nagiginteresado tayo sa isang tao. But I think the lesson is that we need to act on that attraction. We need to act on the attraction. We need to seek out and develop a relationship with that person. And here clearly that is what Herod lacked, no? He was fascinated, he was perplexed, he was attracted by the words of John the Baptist and of Christ, but he never acted on it, no? He never really made a choice. That's the first point that I want us to look at, no? Na nakita natin na si Herod, bagaman meron nga siyang attraction, wala siyang ginawa. Which brings me to the second point, no? That, you know, I think it is important in our prayer life that we must be sensitive to the inner movements of our prayer life. The inner movements of our own person. No? Kasi meron yan, may galaw yan sa loob. Eh. Meron tayong nararamdaman, di ba? Sabi nga yung salita sa Tagalog, may kutob. And I think it's important, no, that we must be able to kumutob, so to speak. No? We must be sensitive to the inner movements in our own life. No? Either spiritually or psychologically, it's to have a sense of the movements of our interior life. No? And I think, remember, I was talking about this maybe a week and a half ago, the need for discernment. And that's the beginning of discernment. Pagka tayo ay kinikilatis natin kung anong nararamdaman natin. That's part of the self-awareness. And the second point is that while it is true that we must be sensitive to the inner movements, part of the sensitivity is, okay, saan ako dinadala nito nung aking spiritual life? Yung galaw ng kalooban ko, yung galaw ng spirito sa loob ko. Where is it leading us? And that is still part of the discernment. And I think it eventually will lead us to make a choice. It will lead us to make a choice to either know Christ or, again, let Him remain in the periphery of our lives. No? And I think we will look at this more tomorrow. No? But let me just bring it to that third point, no? That we must discern. And remember, discernment must lead us to action. And I think the fundamental action is to make a decision on our relationship with Christ. To know Him more, yes, but eventually to move into action of loving Him more and ultimately of following Christ more. So today, let us pray on this gospel, also as a preparation for tomorrow. Tomorrow we have, as I said, nandyan yung tatanungin ng Panginoon, di ba? Sino ako? Sino, anong sabi ng mga ibang tao? Tapos mali lahat. Tapos tatanungin niya ulit, pero kayo, sino ako sa inyo? So today, let us, in a sense, prepare also for tomorrow's gospel by asking ourselves, what are the movements, interior movements of my life? And how have these interior movements somehow led me to that encounter of ano ba talaga yung relationship ko sa Diyos? That invitation to know Him more deeply and to see Him more clearly in our lives. So we will continue this tomorrow, and again, let us pray. Let us pray that we may, you know, at this stage, really deepen our relationship with the Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We are aware that there is much evil in the world. Because Jesus has overcome evil by His death and resurrection, we ask God that goodness may be victorious. To each prayer, our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Pilgrim Church may inspire people to renew their lives by faithfully bearing witness to Christ in word and deed. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That nations may give up the senseless race to have more powerful weapons of war, and that they instead learn to live together in harmony and peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are persecuted because of their beliefs may succeed in winning their freedom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick and the handicapped may receive the comfort of God's love from those engaged in caring for them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died may be freed from the troubles of this world and enjoy everlasting peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And again, we ask you to continue to pray for ABS, praying for the leaders of ABS and also the employees who stay and continue to work and continue the mission of ABS. And let's offer also a special prayer for those who have been retrenched and their families. So please join us in praying, commending ABS to the prayers of our Blessed Mother. And so together we pray, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and in the hour of our death. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, your goodness. We have this bread and this wine to offer. Fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands, they will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these heavenly mysteries. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. With love, we celebrate his death. With living faith, we proclaim his resurrection. With unwavering hope, we await his return in glory. And so, with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. We remember especially those who passed away during this time of the pandemic. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace, the unity and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And together let us pray the Oratio Imperata.
God our Father, we come to you in our need to ask your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and even claimed lives. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem the tide of its transmission. Protect the medical experts that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health soon. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Grant us the grace in this trying time to work for the good of all and to help those in need. We ask for your special providence and protection for the whole world and humanity, our country and our people, our families and our friends. Send your spirit to protect us from this virus. We implore you to stop the spread of this virus and to save us from our fears. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us.
And let us pray. Graciously raise up, O Lord, those you renew with this sacrament, that we may come to possess your redemption, both in mystery and in the manner of our life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.